Opposition common candidate General Sarath Fonseca says his election campaign was launched against corruption and to restore good governance.
We will take the country forward from the war victory to the peace and economic development. Whilst doing that, we will ensure everybody is safe and secured in this country. All the communities are safe and secured. And all communities can live like brothers and sisters and one family. And as we go on, we will ensure their safety and security, their law and order. The women are safe in the country. Women can walk around, walk about without being subjected to any harm in the night, on streets even. Now the situation is different. We will ensure the departments are not politicized. We will ensure there is no political interference with the police. We will ensure the private sector is not interfered, because we will prevent corruption so that the private sector can prosper, and we will ensure the media freedom. So in order to do all these things, finally we will ensure the good governance.
Cabinet spokesman Anura Priyadarshaneyappa says even if General Sarath Fonseca made a false statement on war crimes, the government is obliged to submit reasons with proof to the UN.
This has not happened, yes, but now they are asking proof. How can we give proof now? Now it is up to the government to decide. In the diplomatic level, they will take it up. But what I am saying is, this is somewhere else now. There are. Sarath neve metana thiyen prashne. Sarath kiyanne namak ne. There are lots of past examples like this. We can say, yes, we have replied and we are not worried. But UN has not accepted it. They have asked us to give reasons with proof.
He said I was misquoted.
Okay. That are totally denying something and telling I have been misquoted is two different things.
The army says the outlook of former Tamil Tiger combatants are changing and that they are helping the military to find hidden caches of weapons even after 6 months of the war.
Some cadres, the moment they came, they raised their hand and said, okay, we have some information about hidden armed caches and this and that, so we are ready to give the information. So we took them into those locations and we recovered. Some cadres, they waited for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks, 5 weeks. The moment they felt that the forces and the Commissioner General is treating them very humanly, they gave the information even after 2 months. Even now, after establishing these centers, after about 5 months, still, all of a sudden, they raised their hand, okay, I'm coming to give some information. And arms caches are recovered. So that is the level of, by looking at it, you can see that the mind is changing. Because a hardcore cadre, after 5 months, volunteer to say, without any threat or anything, right? Finally, he volunteers to show us arms caches. So we are recovering a lot of arms caches from Pudumathalan and Vellamulikkal area.
Security Forces Commander Vanni Major General Kamal Gunaratna told reporters Wednesday that the LTT, which was once a powerful fighting force, has been reduced to a mere ideology.
In this period of 2 years and 10 months, we suffered around 23,000 casualties as wounded in action and around 6,000 casualties as killed in action. So in order to get that amount of casualties, there has to be a fight with another powerful organization. Right. During this period, LTT suffered more than 23,000 deaths, and right now we have 12,258 in custody. In custody, in the sense, most of them are in rehabilitation centers and few of them are in prisons. We have reduced this large, well-motivated, well-indoctrinated LTT army down to just an ideology.
Environment Minister Patali Champika Ranavaka says General Fonseca and the opposition are making contradictory statements about the Prime Minister position. Ranavaka made these comments following a report on a weekend newspaper that Ranil Wickremesinghe was planning to be the executive prime minister in a caretaker government.
The Ranil Wickremesinghe mahatya thadanne mokadda Sarath Fonseca mahatyage chande pahavichchi kala nama maru kala etuma vidhayaka agamathi wen. මේක ඇවිල්ලා අන්තිම මහා වංචාවක් මේ රටේ ජනතාවට කරන්නේ. අපි අහනවා මොකද්ද ස්ථාවරය කියලා ජනතායුක්ත කරන්නේ. මොකද්ද ස්ථාවරය මංගල සමර වීරමැතිතුමනි. මොකද එතුමල්ලා දිගටම ප්‍රකාශ කළා මෙවැනි අගමැති ධූරයක් නැහැ. එදාම මේ ගියේ ඉරිදම තවත් ඉරිදා පුවත්පතකට ජවිපනායකතුමා කියලා තිබුණා. කිසිම භාරකාර ආණ්ඩුවේ අගමැති පදවියක් කිසිම බලතල සහිත අගමැති පදවියක් නැහැයි කියලා. ඉතින් මේක තුලින් පෙන්වන්නේ මොකද්ද? කට්ටියක් කියන අගමැති පදවියක් නැහැයි කියලා. කට්ටියක් කියනවා මම අගමැති, නිකං අගමැති නෙමෙයි මම. මම විධායක අගමැති. ආ එතකොට ජනාධිපති ධූර අපේක්ෂකයා කියනවා මට නම් නිකම් බලතල තියෙන අපේ විලියම් ගෝපල්ලෝ මැතිතුමා හිටියා වගේ නාම මාත්‍රික ජනාධිපති කෙනෙක් වෙන්න බෑයි කියලා. එතකොට මොකද මේක තුල තියෙන්නේ? කරන්න යන්නේ මොකද්ද කියන එක ගැන කිසිම එකඟතාවයක් නැති බවයි. රට අවුලෙන් අවුලට පත් කරන බවයි. ඒක නිසා මං හිතන්නේ මේ විධායක අගමැති ධූරය පිළිබඳව ගරු විපක්ෂ නායකතුමා පළ කළ තියෙන අදහස් වලින් එතුමා පෙන්ලා දීලා තියෙන්නේ මේ සරත් පොන්සේක මැතිතුමාගේ ජයග්‍රහණය පිප්පකට් ගහන්න යන බවයි. අපි අහනවා ජනතා විමුක්ති පෙරමුණෙන් විශේෂයෙන්ම මොකද්ද විසඳුම විධායක ජනාධිපති ක්‍රමයේ අහෝසි කළාට පස්සේ පළාත් සභා ක්‍රමයට ඇති වෙන බලපෑමට මොකද්ද විසඳුම කියලා. විධායක ජනාධිපති ක්‍රමයේ අහෝසි කිරීමෙන් පස්සේ පිහිටවන්නේ කුමන රජයක්ද කියන එක, කුමන ආකාරයේ ආණ්ඩු ක්‍රමයක්ද කියන එක දැනගන්න ඕනේ මේ රටේ ජනතාව.
Ranawaka also commented on the expanding cabinet.
මේක මේ අදයි ඇති වෙච්ච ප්‍රශ්නයක් නෙවෙයි. JR ජයවර්ධනගේ ආණ්ඩුවේ හිටියා දිසා ඇමතිවරුත් එක්ක 72 දෙනෙක් ඇමතිවරු. ඒ වගේම රණසිංහ ප්‍රේමදාසගේ ආණ්ඩුවේ එක අවස්ථාවක හිටියා 97ක්. ඒක පස්සේ 91 වුණා. රනිල් වික්‍රමසිංහගේ ආණ්ඩුවේ හිටියා ඔය අවුරුදු දෙකේ 98 දෙනෙක්. නේද මේක මේ මහින්ද රාජපක්ෂ පත්තුනාව ඇති වෙච්ච විශේෂ තත්ත්වයක් නෙවෙයි. මේ අනුපාත ඡන්ද ක්‍රමයේ විසින් ඇති කරන අස්ථාවරත්වේ නිසා නොයෙක් වරදාන දෙන්න වීම නිසා සිදුවෙච්ච දෙයක්. මේ අතීතයේ අමතක කරලා ජම්බෝ කැබිනට් කීකී කෑගාල වැඩක් නැහැ. මේ අමාත්‍ය ධූර ප්‍රමාණයේ තිබුණ ඇත්තටම චන්ද්‍රිකා බණ්ඩාරනායකගේ 94 ඉඳන් 2000 දක්වා ඇරෙන අනික් හැම අවස්ථාවකම 100කට ආසන්න අමාත්‍ය ධූර ප්‍රමාණයක් තිබුණා. ඒක අපි විරුද්ධයි ඒකට. අවංකව අපි කියන්නේ අපි විරුද්ධයි. අපි කියන්නේ අනිවාර්යයෙන්ම විෂය බෙදීමක් සහිතව යම් නිශ්චිත ඇමති ධූර ප්‍රමාණයක් එකඟතාවයක් හදාගෙන ඇති කරගන්න ව්‍යවස්ථාවටම ඇතුල් කළා. අපේ අදහස ඒකයි.
President Mahinda Rajapaksa launched his official election campaign website in Kandy today. The website can be accessed on www.mahinda2010.lk. Meanwhile, common opposition candidate General Sarath Fonseca also launched his official website for the 2010 presidential election campaign. General Fonseca's website can be accessed on www.sarathfonseca.com. The cabinet is to appoint a negotiating committee to evaluate proposals for business ventures at the Hambantota Port Development Project.
Identify these business ventures to be implemented in Hambantota Port in the future. One cement grinding plant, cement bagging plant, fertilizer bagging plant, two numbers, vehicle assembling plant, warehousing complex, operation of LPG plant, operation of RoRo terminals, ship repair facilities, operation on non-containerized cargo terminals, and any other services. In this cabinet paper, the minister requests the cabinet of ministers to approve to appoint a cabinet-appointed negotiating committee and a project committee to prepare and call for requests for proposals from the interest parties for the commencement of business ventures on Hambantota Port development. To evaluate and negotiate with the bidders on their proposal for commencement of business ventures on Hambantota Port Development Project.
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas.
Peace and harmony and fellowship prevails. That's my wish and happiness and fairness prevails.
Merry Christmas to everybody.
We wish our viewers a Merry Christmas. The Met Department says there will be showers at several places in the eastern, Uva, north central provinces and in the Mathale and Hambantota district. Thundershowers will also develop at several places elsewhere during the afternoon or evening. There may be temporarily localized fairly strong winds during thundershowers. The general public is requested to take precautions to minimize damages caused by lightning. You can now follow Debrief on YouTube, Twitter, and Facebook.